Hello, my name is Sönke Petersen and I'm the race designer here. As you may know, we just recently extended our passive race design timing system with an active component so that you can now use passive and active transponders with the same system. And in this video, I would like to show you the main benefits of the active timing system. So maybe you're wondering if the active transponder is also working in water. So just pour the chips, the 50 transponders I have here, in this bucket of water. One of the most important features of the ActivePro transponder is the 3D activation antenna. That means no matter which orientation you hold the transponder, it will always detect. So, and in this bucket, I have 50 transponders orientated in any way, as you can see. So when I walk over the loop, they should all detect. One of the main benefits of an active timing system is the precision. So to test this, I attached two transponders to my bike, one on each fork, and when I cross the line, they should have theoretically roughly the same time. So let's try it out. Besides the active decoder, we also offer the LoopBox. The LoopBox has actually two use cases which are really nice. The first one is the repeat mode. That is really useful when you have several timing lines within a close area. So in this case, I've set up my LoopBox here. My main timing system is over there. The distance can be several hundred meters. What's going to happen is that the LoopBox will activate the transponder, receive a signal and repeat the signal to the main timing system. And of course, the timing system then knows that the detection comes from this loop and not from the loop over there. So I have now 5 transponders, and I will walk with them over the loop and we will see the detections at the main timing system. The second mode of the LoopBox works only with the ActivePro transponder. In this case, the LoopBox will activate the transponder, but the transponder will not transmit its signal. Instead, it starts an internal clock and remembers how long the activation from the LoopBox is ago. When it then reaches the finish, it will get several detections, one from each LoopBox and the final finish detection. So for example, if you have a mountain bike downhill race, you could have the LoopBox at the start, at the top, and the finish system on the bottom of the mountain. And there you will receive 2 detections, the start time and the finish time. So what I'm going to do now is take these 5 transponders, cross the LoopBox, they will turn on the clock, and when I reach the main timing system, I will get 10 detections, 5 from the start loop, and 5 from the finish loop.